Hello guys, welcome to Geology Concepts. In this video, as you can see, I'll discuss about stereographic projections. So first of all, we need to know why we need these stereographic projections. Okay, this I will explain you with an example. Suppose you want to represent a faulted structure. Okay, so I'll show you two ways how you can do that. Okay, first is this one. Okay, where I will draw a very 3D representation. You see, this is a 3D representation. Okay, now I can show this like this also. Again, maybe you can just make the arrows to show the movement. So here you can see that one is very difficult to draw, like this one, and this one is really, really easy. So this is why the stereographic projections are used, to make a work easier, a lot easier. Okay, so now you get many data in your field work and you need to plot a lot of readings. Like you got, suppose, 50 readings of different fault planes showing different depths and strike values. If you had to draw all of them like this one, okay, like this one, I mean, you would definitely abandon the subject, right? But this one, I mean, this, you can think of drawing it. So not to lose a lot of geologists, this technique is used. But you know, there is a quote that in order to gain something, you need to lose something. Okay, and this loss is the loss of some information. And you can say this, that there is a distortion of the data. Okay, this you can, I mean, this can be seen by these two projection techniques. The first is the principle of stereographic projection, and the second is the principle of Lambert projection. Okay, principle of stereographic projection is also known as equal angle net or Wolf net, and principle of Lambert projection is also known as the equal area net and Schmidt net. So commonly we name these by the these two names. So as you can relate by the names, in equal angle net, the angle of the feature is preserved. That is, it remains same. Okay. Whereas in equal area net, the area is preferentially preserved. Okay. So for example, like a circle. Okay, if I draw a circle, this circle would remain a circle, maybe a smaller circle of different area in case of equal angle net or Wolf net. But the same circle, if you plot in equal area net, this circle might become an ellipse with the same area. Okay, so you can see here the angle is preserved and it remains as the circle, but here the area is preferentially preserved. Okay, the circle does not remain a circle anymore, but the area is same. This difference is just due to the different projection techniques used to draw these stereo nets. As you can see here in this diagram, you can see a bit difference. It is generally said that an equal angle net is used in case of crystallography, whereas where we mainly have to deal with the angles. Okay, and an equal area net is used in case of structural geology. But for our purpose, like for the exams like IIT JAM, GATE, NET, etc., we can use the equal angle net, I mean, as well. Okay, and that is our need for this point of time, as we only have to project the strike values and depth values and plunge values. Okay, that deal with mainly the angles, while the equal area net is used by structural geologists at high levels. okay, where a lot of data is present, and an area preservation is needed depending upon the requirement. Okay, so basically it depends on the requirement of your study. Okay. So in this video we'll focus on the principle of stereographic projections. Okay, this is the projection which we see in most of the questions, and that is what we are going to discuss in detail. So these are some of the important structures we need to plot on a stereo net. You can see some planes like this cleavage plane, okay, like a fold limb, and an axial plane, this fold axial plane, this one, and others like a bed and a fault plane, etc. And you can see some of the linear features like this bedding cleavage intersection lineation, this one, and a fold hinge, okay, and some other features like a mineral lineation, slick insides, a pole to a plane, etc. So now we'll understand how we are going to project some features. You can see a east-southeast dipping plane intersecting this hollow sphere. Okay. And the part of the plane that is inside the sphere is this circular part. Okay. This circular part is inside this sphere. Okay. And rest of the plane is outside. Okay. And even if the plane inside this sphere is circular, it's a plane, right? And it is having the same attitude as this square plane. So it will very well do the work. So here you need to note that we use the lower hemisphere of the sphere for plotting these features. So only the part of the plane that is inside the lower hemisphere will be plotted. Okay, and again, even if the plane is a semicircular plane, it's a plane and it will have the same attitude as the circular and the square plane which we saw earlier. Okay, so no difference for our purpose. So you can see this plane inside the southern hemisphere as a semicircular east-southeast dipping plane. And the points of the plane touching the sphere, okay, this hollow sphere, is this semicircular line. And any plane or line drawn in this hemisphere has to pass through the central point O. Okay, like this plane is passing through point O. You cannot draw a plane like this. Okay. Now if you look at this diagram, the part of the plane outside the sphere is excluded. Okay, as we never need that, we just need what is inside it. Now you know that this plane, okay, this gray plane, is touching the sphere along this semicircular line. Okay, the semicircular line. All the points along this line need to be connected to this zenith point. You can imagine it as the North Pole, if this sphere is the Earth. So by the help of these lines, you can see these lines, they are connected. Okay, here they have shown a few of these lines. Okay, but I mean, from each and every point they can be connected to the zenith point. Okay. Now you can see that these lines will intersect this horizontal plane. This horizontal plane, which is called the equatorial plane. Okay, and this equatorial plane is the stereographic projection. Okay, this is the plane which makes our stereo net. Okay, that is where we are going to plot all the data. So you can see here that these lines, these connecting lines, intersect the projection plane, okay, or the equatorial plane at these points. Okay, if you draw more lines, you will get a lot of points, right? If you draw more connecting lines. So by connecting these lines, these points, okay, marked in blue, we get a line like this. Okay, the line I have drawn with this blue color. This blue colored line is the projection of the semicircular plane on this projection plane, okay, which is the stereo net you get for your lab work. And these are the north, south, east and west directions on your stereo net. Now if you got a linear feature like this, suppose I'll change the color maybe like this. This is a linear feature on this plane. So this line is touching the sphere only at one point, okay, which is this point. So what you have to do is you just have to connect that point, okay, this point to the zenith, okay, only one point you have to connect. This way you will get only one point on the projection plane, which is the projection of this linear feature. Okay. Now what you have to do is just connect this point with the zenith. Okay. And this connecting line will intersect at this point. It's not clearly visible. I'll change the color to red. Okay. This is the point. You see where this connecting line will intersect the projection plane. Okay, so you see you get the projection of this line as this point. Now you must have noticed that a plane becomes a line on projection and a line becomes a point. And this is what make things easier for us, right? I mean, it's very easy to draw a line and a point compared to a plane. Okay. So I have included both of these stereo net for comparison purpose. You can see that in equal angle net, these lines become a lot circular towards the periphery. Okay, but in equal area net, you can see that these are quite elliptical. Okay. Now, if I show you some important labelings, these lines, okay. These lines are called the great circles, which look like the longitudes on the earth, okay. And these lines are called the small circles. Okay, which look like the latitudes. Okay, and this is the north. Okay, this east, south and west part. Now the angle you measure is like this. Okay, this is 0 degree, this is 10 degree, this is 20, okay, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90 in the center. Okay, if it's a vertical plane, it will just be a straight line like this. If the plane is a horizontal plane, then the plane would be like this, just tracing the outer part of this stereo net. Okay, and these are also the angles. Okay, this is 10 degree, okay, 20 degree and 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 and 90 in the center. And same way it's done in this equal area net also. And all these lines, you can see all these lines are drawn, and here also are drawn by using the projection technique of these respective stereo nets. So this was all for this video. I hope you understood the concepts. And if you like the video, share it with others. Ask your questions in the comments. And if you want to join our live classes for IIT JAM, GATE, NET, GSI, etc., you can fill the form and attend the demo classes, which are absolutely free of cost. Okay, so all the details are given in the description of this video. So see you then in my next video. Bye bye.